quantum friends. Lately, I... Channel switch. Channel switched.
Can't get any worse than this.
Klipsch 120SW Damn Generation Review. Let's run naming scheme analysis.
Klipsch 12 inches 0 effort.
So my wonderful quantum loving friends, this will be a complicated review experience. If you are more interested in 10 inches version or similar, you may find this also pretty interesting. My guess experience may be similar. I don't know why Klipsch is in so much controversy. In a world wide web was opinion not to buy RP280. But I did, and I love speakers, great floor standing loudspeakers, still doesn't disappoint me. So same goes for Klipsch subs, hardly anyone can recommend Klipsch sub. Everyone talking about SVS, but in this video, you will know about this budget subwoofer, what is called 120SW. And everything is not so simple. By the way, don't forget to write something down about short film in comments. Do I need to submit it in Netflix or something? As a logical human being, you will ask me why I didn't buy some really good and widely appreciated sub. And to answer to your question, no, I'm not a Klipsch fanboy. Also, why didn't I go for the SVS 2000, etc. And answer is, I really don't need a sub. It was just an experiment. I need cheap as possible what will complement my system. And I just can't just buy some Skytech garbage. I need something decent, because I watch movies basically every day. And did you know that there is a sound guy who is making surround sound like 5.1 audio. And if you watch stereo, you just can't hear what he did, right? And if you will say,
but what if he did a bad job?
Then I will answer that you can turn off sub anytime you want and write a review in IMDb that sound guy made a bad sound. And yes, after some research I was triggered and just YOLO instant purchase. Also, I need to address fact that I'm living in apartments. So that's another big reason why I did go for this sub, because I care about my neighbors. Funny thing to say when you buy a sub, right? But anyway, my neighbors are good people, and I'm nice to them. I especially search for the sub what can't reproduce clean 20 Hz sound, and I don't need to duck around with limiters and stuff. So also, in my opinion, was a good choice for my apartment. Probably. For the last reason, there is people who say size doesn't matter. But not for me. 12 inches is minimum for my sub. It need to complement me. First of all, price, price, price. I read on the World Wide Web that you can buy a better sub for that money. I don't know where. Maybe in America, but not at my place. Klipsch is one of the most affordable. Okay, so I bring this box home. And first of all, sub is extra light. Couple of my amps are heavier than this sub, and that is a never good sign. Second thing what confused me, that there already was attached legs. You just unpack it, connect it, and that's it. No assembly needed. No proof. You are covered. Sub build is understandable, because my floor-tending loudspeakers have these cheapo rubbers around speakers. On a sub is screws. That is neat stuff. For people who are a bit autistic and love matching everything perfect,
speakers look different.
Then you can always put black cover grill on, and everything will look the same, black. And yes, you can see green light diode through black cover. Next thing you realize is this terminal. Then I remembered my first sub, like 10 years ago. It has so many connections, and knobs, and buttons, that I was really confused. What to do? How to connect? Can it amplify my speakers? So many questions. And this have two knobs, two switches, and two RCA connections. Holy lag. And that's it. Then I realized. How do I level sound? And trust me, it was pain in the ass. For every movie I need to put different volume. I need to stand up and again, turn down this knob, turn up this knob. It never was too right. Because I used headphone splitter from my TV headphone exit and split signal to amp and the sub with this cable. Started to regret that there is no speaker terminals. Also, I kept low pass down to 40 to get somewhat enjoyable sound, because it was just unusable. Sound was just rumbling, it was just horrible, painful experience. Started to think maybe it's not too late to return it. But I decided not to give up. All my life I hated receivers. 5.1 channels, 7.1, 0.4 channels, I just loved. I have like 10 super cool stereo amps, even lamp ones. Why do I ever need receiver? Who buys that shit? I thought. In short, I will make another video about this topic. So stay tuned, maybe subscribe, you know. Spoiler alert. Guess what? I bought one. I mean receiver. And my life changed forever. Still think that computer would be a better choice. And receiver still is a bit crap. But when I connected this sub to receiver. And guess what? I don't need sub anymore. After room correction and other stuff like equalizer, my nice speaker started to produce more bass. Perfectly fine for my taste. Okay, what about sub? Did not more rumble and started to produce normal. Even a good sound. So lesson learned. Don't connect it to stereo signal. If you're normal, of course. For me, this sub is meant to be used only with audio processor. And LFE, and this whole. That's the only way how to use it in my experience. Now, when I watch movies, I even can enjoy movie and not to think about regulating my sub. and 1-3 times per movie I get really surprised. First thing you can say about almost any new Klipsch speaker, that they look good and they have this special orange accent woofer, signature stuff of Mr. Klipsch. Of course, nowadays orange is considered a swear word or something, but Klipsch is a Klipsch. Around woofer there are screws, but actually I like more than rubber sheet, but falls off when some Neanderthal fingering it. Box is made of beautiful reinforced MDF. Front and back panel have some cheaper material, but still I don't mind the color change. Looks a bit cheaper, but somehow pretty modern. So like I said in 280 speaker review, I love magnetically attached grill. Nice stuff. Hate packs. I remember when old days kids break them off. Magnets are absolutely best solution, but with subwoofer it's not an option. It will vibrate. So what did Klipsch do? They came up with this pretty solid solution. I like it a lot. They attached hard and stiff metal packs on a subwoofer itself, and you put grill on with a force. You can feel that it won't vibrate. Very good solution. And good grill, of course. Front light is not too bright, but visible from the sofa. Also, Klipsch did right thing here. So far, everything is almost perfect. Also, legs are screwed hard, so you won't lock up even here. You won't screw them too loose, and sub will vibrate. So good choice to ship it with legs attached. But unfortunately, the backside situation is a bit different. Like in restaurant, the front is good. But in the kitchen, Mr. Engineer Klipsch did less attention to detail. There you can see why it's a budget sub. It doesn't have steps. Once again, it shows that you just leave it at 40% and keep it there, and receiver will do the rest. Just don't touch it. But yes, I don't like that it uses smooth knob. Face have two positions. As you know, some fancy subs have a knob there. In my case, I'm not so picky, but still, it is how it is. Don't be fooled about power switch. This switch have three positions, so you just need to leave it in the middle. In the middle of it is auto mode, where it will turn on when it receives signal and turn off when not. And of course, there is permanent on and off. Also, power cord is short, but it's typical VHS power cord, so I guess you can buy a longer one. And last thing, if you look inside in the back exhaust hole, you can see that the tube is made from paper, what is typical. Also, you can see the actual woofer, which actually looks pretty good, but still no foam, no nothing. It's seems strange to me. Also, if some smartass will drop something inside, you will have a hard time to get it out. Probably need to go to the doctor. So yes, now you know everything about this sub. BBB. That means big black box. Now after this YOLO purchase, let's explore official specs. 12 inches, 30.5 centimeters, front firing spun copper IMG woofer. Who jealous now? That size, right? The girls in us are interested. Spun copper IMG woofer injected molded graphite. Klipsch says that woofers are exceptionally light while being extremely rigid, providing remarkable low frequency response with minimal cone breakup and distortion. All digital amplifier with 400 watt peak power. How good amp is hard to say. When it will die, I will investigate. So once again, subscribe. Approximately 180 watts will be constant power of this sub in my knowledge. Frequency response 29 Hz to 120 Hz, plus minus 3 dB. A bit down Reno, but it is what it is, and but that is what I needed, because I'm good neighbor. Maximum acoustic output 116 dB. Volume, low pass crossover and pass control. Klipsch thinks it's a feature, right? Line level, LFE RCA input or maximum receiver compatibility. Yes, now I see that they even write down in official page word receivers. Dimensions. Not the smallest box. Hard to hide somewhere. So be aware of the size. Weight. 31 units or 14 kilograms. Very light sub. Too light. They needed at least hide their bricks or something. But maybe technology go on, and lighter is better now. Black textured wood grain vinyl. It's pretty good, I like the finish. Built from 2018. Also Klipsch described this speaker, so quote from their website. The Klipsch subwoofer designed, inspiring bass music, IMG, so produced clean bass system. So. What can I comment about it? I don't listen at maximum volume. Maybe 1/4, so it's alright with me considering the price. Also there is no ultra bullshit like some Sony products. Simple and pretty believable spec, especially weight. Now I'm watching movies on 4.1 system, sometimes 5.1 system. To enjoy full experience or disappointment, because lately movies are bad. For me the best question I can ask for myself is, are Klipsch 1-0SV compliment my system? And the answer is, yes. I won't comment much about sound signature because sub is doing very specific function and it can't live alone. You need to have a good speakers and sub can only compliment you or ruin your experience. It just add a little, add feeling to the movie. Tension, or is it suspense, maybe car rumbling or something, you know. Sub is like waitress in a restaurant, but bring you food. So I'm not blown away by this service, but also because I had so low expectation at the beginning and horrible experience, to be honest. Now I'm pretty fine and will explore 5.1 in the future. In short, this is not a bad sub to start with. Also, I need to disclose that 280 is very powerful and sub really is only a small portion of experience. I easily can live without sub. But is it complimenting my system? Yes, it is. Sometimes, when in movie excavator dropped that horse in a grave, that sound really is full. Good, full, clean sound of impact. You can feel how horse hit the grave. So for me, it's just really an extra, and when movie makers do a great job with sound, you can appreciate it more. Also, my neighbor is still greeting me and smiling, so it seems like everything is fine in 20Hz regards. Also, small fact that I don't watch Avengers. I'm more mystery drama person. For music, this sub is not great, but not terrible. 3.6 out of 5. So let's start what to not do. If you was like me, who were using stereo 2.0 and want to add sub with a splitter from TV headphone exit, this is not sub what will complement your system. I will suggest to buy bigger front speakers. And that's it. But if you really want sub and don't have a receiver or sound processor, even a PC, you will have a hard way to go. If you have a big front speaker, think twice about this sub. Maybe it's enough. Try to mess with equalizer and room correction tools. And if still after all this you think you need a sub, you can go for it. For starters, 1-0SV not the worst choice. In my opinion, of course. I heard so many bad subs and this definitely is solid. I'm even surprised. If you don't have a space for sub, maybe don't buy it. One very important thing is placement of the sub. And if you have only one place to place it, imagine in that place sub is producing bad sound, bad bass. Sub is like rich woman who can annoy you, change your life or divorce with you. And you need to move, live somewhere else. Be aware. Also I like that I can sit on it, it's stable. I sometimes use it as chair. That's a great feature. And of course, the best feature of all is the price. I think it's very affordable. In my place, nothing compete for this size and price. Also, I need to address that there is big rumors that Klipsch active amps are garbage. So there, I think, is two explanations for that. Maybe demand for them is really big and many people have them. So that small percentage of owners who get faulty subs are more visible in World Wide Web. But to be honest, I don't think that amp quality is good. You just need to remember that this is mass-produced sub that is made in China. And it stands in budget category. So in case amp will fry, then I will make another video where I will investigate what did go wrong and DIY this sub. Definitely will add some bricks to gain some weight. Maybe we change a box, who knows, not a problem for me anyway. One more thing, I feel like this sub is noob proof. Sub is ready out from the box. Heavy only one connection, one knob, another knob and a couple more things, you know. So without your processor you will be covered. If not, leave it on minimum and struggle. Some Klipsch subs have a wireless connections. I don't like anything flying in my home. I like cables. So I'm more like snake people. So I didn't try wireless version. But if you did, please tell me how was latency, how was signal, etc. In case everything is fine, then you need only one cable. World is getting simpler. Also, fun fact that I can turn on some music and every of my friends will tell me what a great sound and what a clean bass, even in case when sub is actually turned off. So even when sub is off, it giving great placebo effect. If you have a question like, if my floor standing speaker can do everything what sub can do, then answer is not. Of course, floor standing speakers can do a lot more than sub, but subwoofer is the bass king. And subwoofer bass is definitely more feelable and bigger. At the end, I want to say, if you're living in an apartment, you don't need sub. Better go for center channel. Be a good neighbor. Don't make this affair with this rich woman. This was hard day. I'm actually not sure that I'm told everything that I needed to told. So maybe if I forget something, please remind me in comments what I did forget. Guys, thanks for watching. If you watch this far, you get my great respect. Also, I do this new thing. You can leave hashtag #TameGeneration in comments under this video. And if you do so, I will answer to your comment live in the next video, at the end of the video. So don't be shy. For example, if you have this sub or other Klipsch subs, tell me your experience here or in Reddit. Love to hear other opinions. Shout out to long lasting subs who always supported me. Thank you guys. With a big loving buzz, see ya in the next video. Have a nice headshots.